first time I went to foster care, I was about 6. We really liked the home and thought we were going to stay there, but found out that our grandparents were still alive, so we moved in with our grandparents. My grandma died of breast cancer and my grandpa died from Alzheimer's. When I got back to the foster home, the foster mom had started going crazy, and so they moved us. And then when I turned 18, found out that I had to move so another girl could move in.
We got in contact with a foster care worker.
We were just looking for information.
Right.
We were looking for data, looking for statistics. We were looking for future resources.
So I called up my caseworker and told her I had nowhere to go. I was going to have to sit on the side of the road.
And she called the next day and said, "So I have a young lady who needs a home tonight." And we said, and there she was. AOT stands for Aged Out Teens. And an aged out teen is a youth that has been in the foster care system that aged out, turned 18 before they were adopted into a permanent family. The unlimited part is very literally that, it's unlimited. We don't want to feel confined in structure, I suppose. We don't want to be limited by who we can let in, by how, what they are capable of doing. If somebody comes to us and they don't fit within our neat little structure, we can't turn them loose. We have to just find something that works for them.
Well, back in August, September, we went to an adoption seminar, and we were touched by some videos that we had watched that showed a young man, I believe it was, and he was talking about being an aged out teen. And one of the things that hit us was that when you turn 18 and after you've been released from state care, you've turned 18 and you don't have a family, you don't have somebody to call on when you need help, when you are having a bad day, when you break up with a girlfriend or boyfriend, when your car breaks down. And so we decided to go home and do some research and find out what kind of programs there were out there to help the aged out teens, and there were very few.
Amanda and I feel drawn to this from mostly because of pains that we've gone through and our own personal wounds. And the benefit of that is that we are now in a position where we can help people that have gone through likewise pains. Where we see it going is like I said, unlimited. It's everything. We don't want to feel limited by anything we do. We want to help everybody, and unfortunately that's going to take quite some time to get going that far. We'll need a great deal more funding than what we're getting right now, which is almost nothing. Somebody's being guided by God to join in, give us a call. We need volunteers for all sorts of things. Anybody can be a mentor. No matter what it is you do, no matter what your expertise or your hobby, somebody else wants to learn it too. Just if you want to help, just raise your hand. There's something you can do.
Yeah, this is home.